This morning in Family Time, we're getting into the Halloween spirit with some fun crafts that the kids can enjoy this weekend. The Mod Mommy, Courtney Caligiuri, is here with us. That's the name of your blog.
Yeah.
Right? Mod Mommy.
Who knew?
I love that.
Mod Mommy. That's me.
Right. You are. And I think a lot of moms out there.
Yeah.
Are, you know.
Very modern.
Exactly.
It's catching on.
It is. You have a lot of great tips on there, especially too, that you do with your own kids.
Yeah.
You have three of them.
Lots of crafts, activities, anything to not pass the time, but, you know, keep them busy. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think activities are great around any holiday, particularly Halloween, because you can have a lot of fun and it doesn't have to be overly scary.
Of course, when they're little too. And I love Halloween too, because it's like the first of the big holidays that are coming.
Mm-hmm.
So lots of things you can do, from cooking and crafts, which we have here.
Okay, so let's get to it. This is the first craft that
cute,
we are
right?
making today.
This is a DIY paper lantern. I don't know if you can tell, but it's on. This is a ghost here. And this is like a treat bag I had from a birthday party over the summer. So you can honestly use a lunch bag. It doesn't matter. I happen to have white, so I was like, let's go with it. Let's go with the ghost here.
Okay.
So all I did was draw a little face on there. Here's if you want to do this with a black marker.
And you want to do it on the side, because I know there's almost like a flap on the side.
You want to do it like on the flat side.
Okay.
To be honest, if you don't have a black marker, which you may not, you can just cut out the eyes
just
and the mouth.
Just any sort of like
face. Because it'll shine through. So I happen to have a Sharpie, but if you don't, you can just, you know, cut holes in there and no big deal.
So kind of weird.
Yeah. And here's a tip you do want to do. If you can see here, this is the button to turn the flashlight on. Don't go completely over it, because you want to be able to obviously turn it on and off. So kind of like just like 2 inches worth. And I'll take your flashlight here. Look at, hey, eyebrows.
He looks tired.
Tired ghost. You know what? The parent should hold that one on Halloween. That'll be my DIY paper lantern.
I've had enough trick-or-treating.
All right, so we can open that up.
Okay.
I mean, it's super simple.
And then just wrap it around?
Yep, so, and then you just put it around, you know, nice and tight.
This is good, so the kids can hold it and maybe the parents
Yep, she did that, and we can do this one super quick, but I mean, you can't get quicker than this in terms of, this is really messy.
I love that, and then you can walk around.
Look how cute that is.
Holding these while you're trick-or-treating.
Yeah.
It's going to be dark.
It's last minute, so if you're looking for something to do that day or the day before, you probably have lunch bags, scissors, tape. Good to go.
Perfect. Also, scissors, tape needed for our next little project here.
I love toilet paper projects, because you have so many. I don't know if you remember, we did one on Valentine's Day with like the stamping.
Yes.
I've done a toilet paper tube turkey. This is toilet paper tube Frankenstein with a popsicle stick. Basically, I had my daughter color some white paper, because had she not colored it, I would have been doing all the pasting and everything else. So she helps by coloring, and I glued it on, put some googly eyes, and just like cut his hair up. It's just a cute centerpiece. If you've got pumpkins and other things around, these fill up nice in the house.
Also, if you have a full roll of toilet paper, have you ever played the mummy game where you wrap someone up in all the toilet paper?
You could do that.
And then you can wrap toilet paper
actually the toilet paper roll the other way and make a mummy too. If you have multiple kids, you can try to make
different things.
Yes.
Okay. Last but not least, this is so sweet.
I'm big always on handprint crafts too, because when they're so little, you just want to like preserve their little hands. So this is a spider, and all you have to do, this is an easy tip, 4 fingers and the palm. So all they're basically doing is putting their whole hand down twice. So you would just flip it around.
Great.
So you've got both fingers. He's eating a little fly here. And I made a little web for her, but it's cute.
Chloe signed it too. Very nice. Yeah, you can draw around it. You can add some googly eyes once it's dry.
Yeah, whatever you want to do. I mean, these are really easy, and kids love to get messy. My kids glue, paint. I mean, they'll be fine. So
it's going to be everywhere. And then they're going to be hopped up on sugar.
Exactly.
All right. If you'd like to make these adorable crafts with your little ones this weekend, just head on over to our website, roadshow.com, where we're going to post the full instructions. Courtney will be back on Monday, too, for another fun Halloween craft using pumpkins.
Yes.